I have heard that the unhappy soul of Shandani lives here. I saw it in my crystal ball. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Madame Olga, world-renowned psychic and card reader. And just for you, I shall read your palms.
Whatever you're selling, lady, I don't want any.
What? No wonder you are so unhappy. I have heard from a friend of yours that your love life is stuck in the Arctic ice pack. That your future is murky and cloudy, and your very soul is withering with an unknown decision from someone else. In general, I know that you are suffering from a very bad case of fruit flies of the heart.
Your friend must be reading my mail.
It does not have to be this way. No, it can change with just a flicker of an eyelash or a snap of a gypsy finger. If you would just let Madame Olga come into you and grasp the levers of your destiny and point them your way, let me read your fortune.
Oh, look, I don't believe in fortune tellers. I don't play games. And the last gypsy I ever met stole my watch, but, yeah, go ahead, read my fortune.
Wait, I'm getting a contact. I'm being channeled from the past. What is the Chandler's name? The Chandler is Seymour.
Chandler named Seymour.
They come in all kinds. Oh, I see a very handsome young man. He lives for danger. He has the look of excitement and adventure and women in his eyes.
Sounds like my kind of man. What's his name?
Sean. Sean Donnelly, did you?
Oh, now how did I know that? Oh, tell me something. Is this clairvoyance contagious? Because I haven't had all my shots in a long time.
It says here that a very beautiful woman has come into your life. This beautiful woman is elegant and gorgeous and provocative and sexy and brilliant. She is brilliant. She has the best legs outside of Radio City.
I tell them the fortune here, you're giving a commercial for a dating service.
Wait. It's clouding over. I see that you have gone to this woman and you have begged for her hand in marriage, and it turns out this woman has eggs but brains. She has put you on the line.
Yeah. Hung by the neck until dead, whichever can
stop. Oh, stop it! The clouds are moving. They're moving out. I know this woman's reasons. This woman has very bad reasons because you have a very romantic and dangerous life. You have had women. That many women you've had?
Well, it only seems like that many.
Oh, this Tiffany, she wants to be sure that if you are the one, that you will love her. Not a two-week stand. No, no, no. And that if you marry her, that it will be all adventure and loving, and you won't get the mood to leave again from her.
Even if I tell her that that's just not going to happen, I love her beyond distraction.
Oh, this Tiffany needs to hear those words very badly.
What does she want from me?
Tiffany? Tiffany? She wants to live the rest of her life with you. She wants you to forgive her for testing you in such a way. She wants to do away with all the games, no more games. If you ask her one more time to marry her, fast as a speeding moonbeam. Tiffany has to know. I have to know what to tell Tiffany. What? Are you going to ask her to marry her again or what?
Tell her, I'll think about it.
You know, It hardly seems fair to all the other women in this world.
What, that you're here with me?
Oh, no. Here we have a financial genius. Very attractive one at that. I mean, that should be your quota in life, right?
Not necessarily.
All right, well, let's throw in a four-star cook. What else is there that I don't know about?
Well, it's easier to show you than to tell you.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I dance.
Okay. Let's dance. Mm. Our memory gets you?
Yeah, you're very perceptive.
Julian.
I always dreamed, actually, that he'd come back. And then, all of a sudden, in 2 days' time, I find out he's dead, and I turn around and I see you. It's a bit much.
Mm. You know, I often thought when Holly died that was it as far as love and romance were concerned.
Well, I think we're coming from the same place.
Perhaps. But I don't think we're in any shape for it tonight.
Oh, wait a minute. I don't want you to go.
And you talk me into it.
Oh, Julian, you have the most wonderful back. So strong.
Good intentions, Madam Olga, but you really don't know everything that goes on in Tiffany's heart, now do you?
But of course I do. I am the greatest mind reader in all of Romany Kingdom.
Well, then you don't have to ask me whether or not I'm ever going to propose to Tiffany again, because you already know.
No. Gypsy custom has it. You have to speak these words aloud in order for the charm to take effect.
Look, I know Tiffany hired you to cast a spell over me with spiced unicorn horns and snake rattlers and a tasty sauce. But all I can say right now...
Oh, would you stop this? Honestly and truly, Sean, how many times do I have to tell you that I'm sorry?
I don't know. Let's see. One,
oh, two, stop this. You know, I did this because I was scared. I was scared. I mean, I didn't know what else to do. Suddenly all this... I was getting the man that I wanted, that I've loved, and you loved me as much as I loved you, and I don't know. I just panicked, and I didn't know how to stop it after that. I didn't.
See what happens when you play games?
All I know what to do is tell you I love you.
And that's all you have to do. Look, I don't just love you. I adore you and all the nutty, crazy things that you do. And yes, of course I want to marry you. That's never stopped. It's never changed. But this time... Miss Tiffany Hill... Fortune teller extraordinaire of the month. Are you going to give me your hand in marriage or what?
Yes. Yes, yes, yes.